We were reading the second part of 100 Dresses. What had happened over there? What is the major thing that has happened? What is the major thing that had happened? Yeah? The teacher had announced the results of the painting competition, and the teacher also informed the students about one thing more. What was that? Yes, that Wanda has left the school, right? So what was the reaction of the two girls after this? What did Peggy and Maddie do? They were feeling bad, right? Maddie was feeling very, very bad that she did not, they had realized the mistake. They wanted to say sorry. And where did they go to? Boggins Heights. That is where Wanda lived. Were they able to find her? No. And what did her house look like? What did Wanda's house look like? It was old but clean. But was Wanda there? No. Then what did the girls decide to do? What did the girls decide? They decided to write a letter. Very good, Bhavin. Yes, they decided to write a letter. But in that letter, did they say sorry? Did they say sorry? No. Yes, wear mask properly, please. They did not say sorry. And if they had said sorry, then how would have things changed? Is it so difficult to say sorry? It's not difficult to say sorry if you really care about how much you have hurt the other person, right? But they did not say sorry. They asked about Wanda. They asked about her school, right? Everything. And where did they write the letter to? What was the address on the envelope? To her old address. And what was written on the top? Please forward. So they thought that, yes, the post office people would be knowing a forwarding address. And did they get a reply? They kept on waiting and waiting. There was no reply. But then suddenly one day, the teacher told them something very strange, very surprising. What was that? There was a letter from Wanda, and she had given her address also. So the teacher was quite happy that now she knows where Wanda is. She would be able to send the medal. And yes, did Wanda miss her old school? Yes, she missed her old school. And do you think she's made friends over there? What did she have to say about the 100 dresses? About the paintings? So she wanted that the girls should take. And did she give any painting in particular to the girls? Yes, one to Maddie and one to Peggy, right? So of course, these beautiful paintings that she had made, one she wanted to give to Maddie and the other she wanted to give to Peggy, right? And so these girls are very surprised that Wanda remembers them, and she has also given her these beautiful paintings, right? So what was so special? When was this letter received? When did the teacher read this letter? Yeah, one day before the holidays, right? So it was their Christmas holidays. And of course, here, what has been described, a beautiful Christmas atmosphere has been described. So let's read this page now. Yes, let's continue. On Saturday, Maddie spent the afternoon with Peggy. They were writing a letter. They were writing a letter to Wanda Petronsky. It was just a friendly letter telling them about the contest and telling Wanda she had won. They told her how pretty her drawings were, and they asked her if she liked where she was living and if she liked her new teacher. They had meant to say they were sorry, but it ended up with they just writing a friendly letter, the kind they would have written to any good friend. So what do we call the letters that you write to friends? Informal letters, right? So when you write to your friends, you write so many things. You write your feelings, you write your happy moments, you write your sad moments, isn't it? Right? They signed it with lots of X's for love. They made the letter to Boggins Heights, writing please forward on the envelope. So we had read this, I think so. Yes. Yeah. So now the teacher has shown them the letter that they had. have received. Yeah. And now they are on their way, right? Let's read from here, I think so. On the way, page 78. On the way home from school, Maddie and Peggy held their drawings very carefully. All the houses had wreaths and hollies in their windows. What are wreaths and hollies? Wreaths are flower arrangements, right? So as in a ring, right? Holly, it's a special kind of a plant which is especially, you know, used for Christmas decoration, right? So there's holly. And so every way people had decorated the houses for Christmas. Outside the grocery store, hundreds of Christmas trees were stacked. Because what do people keep in their homes on Christmas? Christmas trees? Yes, so many trees were there. And in the windows, candy peppermint sticks. Candy sticks, then different flavors and different colors, all there. And cornucopias of shiny transparent paper were strung. So decorations with this shiny paper were there, beautiful hangings and all, right? So we have these decorative things hanging over there. The air smelled like Christmas. The smell of the Christmas trees, the smell of the wreath, the holly, the smell of the Christmas cake. Isn't it? That's an important part of Christmas also. Yes. And light shining everywhere reflected different colors on the snow. So it's snowing. And the light from the shops, the light from the decorations being reflected. So it must be a very beautiful atmosphere. Boy, said Peggy, this shows she really likes us. What shows that she really likes us? That especially she has given two paintings, which are to be given to... one to Maddie and the other to Peggy. That means she's no longer angry. She's a friend. Right? It shows that she got our letter and this is her way of saying that everything's all right and that's that. Peggy is in a way a little casual also, isn't it? Right? So she's not as sensitive as Maddie. And so she's very happy. Okay, she's our friend and everything is fine and she's not angry with us. Right? I hope so, said Maddie. Sadly, she felt sad because she knew she would never see the little tight-lipped polished girl again. The silent polished girl, Wanda, and couldn't ever really make things right between them. What do you think Maddie wanted to do? Between them. She wanted to say sorry, right? Yes, so she wanted to say sorry, she wanted to meet her and make her feel that yes, everything is all right because Maddie has realized her mistake. Yes, absolutely. She went home and she pinned her drawing over a torn place on the wall, in the pink flowered wallpaper in the bedroom. The shabby room came alive from the brilliancy of the colors, the beautiful colors. One was the blue one, blue dress she got Maddie. Yes, yeah. The shabby room came alive from the brilliancy of the colors. Maddie sat down on her bed and looked at the drawing. She had stood by and said nothing, but Wanda had been nice to her anyway. So who was more strong, Wanda or Peggy and Maddie? Wanda, in spite of them teasing, she still had the courage to forgive them. She still thought of them as her friends, right? Tears blurred her eyes and she gazed for a long time at the picture. Then hastily she rubbed her eyes and studied it intently. The colors in the dress were so vivid. So the colors were there, so bright, nice, right? So the colors there in the dress was so vivid that she had scarcely noticed the face and head of the drawing. She was looking at the drawing only. She was looking at the beautiful dress that she did not notice that the drawing had a face also, right? But it looked like her, Maddie. And the face in the painting looked like whom? Maddie. It really looked like her own mouth. Why it really looked like her own self? Wanda had really drawn this for her. Excitedly, she ran over to Peggy. So she wanted to show Peggy that, see, this drawing Wanda had made for me. She's made my face wearing this beautiful dress. So she ran over immediately to her friend's house. Peg, she said, let me see a picture. What's the matter? Asked Peggy as they clattered up to her room and Wanda's drawing was lying face down on the bed. See, Maddie's just Peggy has put the painting like that on the bed. Otherwise, Maddie is very, very caring and concerned. She's immediately gone and pinned it because she's very happy that Wanda has, you know, thought about her. Look, she drew you. That's you, she exclaimed. And the head and the face of this picture did look like Peggy. The picture which Peggy got, it was of Peggy. The picture that Maddie got, it was of Maddie. Right? So that means Wanda had drawn these two girls. What did I say, said Peggy. She must have really liked us anyway. So Peggy, once again, very casual, she said, see, I told you she liked us. She's drawn us. Yes, she must have, agreed Maddie. And she blinked away the tears that came every time she thought of Wanda standing alone in the sunny spot in the schoolyard, looking stolidly over at the group of laughing girls after she had walked off. And after she had said, sure, 100 of all them lined up. So Maddie, you know, when she thought of that, when she looked at the picture, she became very, you know, like, of course, teary and emotional. And she's remembering about that little girl. They used to tease her. And look at her, how she behaved. She gave them beautiful paintings, right? She did not have any, you know, ill will about them. She did not feel so annoyed at them. And she always had thought of them as a friend. Right, let's see. What did the girls write to Wanda? What did they write in the letter? Yes. So they were asking about a new school, a new friends, everything, right? Yes. Did they get a reply? They didn't get a reply. Yes, they didn't get a reply, but she wrote to the teacher, right? Yes. Who was more anxious for a reply, Peggy or Maddie? Maddie was more, right? How do you know? Because, yeah, so she kept on waiting and she's wondering why she's not replying and why they've not got the letter. Now, how did the girls know that Wanda liked them even though they had teased her? Yes, so she gave them these two beautiful pictures. And when they looked closely at the picture, the faces were of those girls. One was Maddie and the other was Peggy. Yes, you please wear your mask properly. Then wear a tight one. No, you're not sitting like this in the class. Okay. Now let's go to these questions. Okay, what do we say about Wanda? I have written Wanda was forgiving. I've written Wanda was understanding. I've written Wanda was brave. If Wanda was brave, then why didn't she stop the girls from teasing her? Why didn't she stand up? Why didn't she tell the teacher? Then she wouldn't have to leave the school. Very nice answer, Bhavin, because she thought that even if they were teasing her, they're talking to her. Otherwise, did Wanda have any friend? No. So that was the only time when the girls talked to her. So she let it continue. And even though, yes, she thought that these girls, they stop her, they talk to her every day. And even if it is asking about the number of dresses, at least they consider her a friend. Okay? Yes. Now, why do you think Wanda's family moved to a different city? Because we have read over there and her father was upset. And he did not like the way his children were being teased because of their long names. And so he thought in a bigger city, people would not be bothered. So he decided to shift. And do you think life there was going to be different for their family? How is life going to be different from them in the bigger city? In a bigger city, there will be people from more different communities. There might be people like them also having names like them. And yes, so they would feel that bonding with them they would not feel so out of place, and people would not tease them, right? So there might be many more communities like theirs from different places. Maddie thought her silence was as bad as Peggy's teasing. Was she right? This is very, very important. Maddie was silent when Peggy used to ask the question. She was a part of the teasing which Peggy did. Was she as guilty as Peggy? Was she as guilty or more guilty? She was guilty because she could have stopped her friend. She could have said no, but she didn't have the courage, right? So she was as bad. So when you are there allowing something wrong to happen, you are a culprit yourself. If you're not stopping any wrongdoing, right? You become a participant. Okay, Hardik, wear your mask properly. Peggy says, I never thought she had the sense to know you were making fun of her. Anyway, I thought she was too dumb. And gee, look how she can draw. What led Peggy to believe that Wanda was dumb? Did she change her opinion about her later? Why did she think that Wanda was dumb? Because she never said anything about their teasing. She thought of them as a friend, right? Yes, and of course, she did not know that she was such a brilliant artist. But later on, her opinion about her changed, right? So when, of course, they saw her winning a prize, right, for the drawing competition, and later on, when they realized that she's left the school, they realized the mistake, and then things started changing, okay? So what was the turning point? What was the major incident that made the girls realize their mistake when she left the school? What important decision did Maddie make? Why did she have to think hard to do so? Yes, so she made a promise to herself that in future, if anybody tries to tease anybody, she's going to immediately stand up and stop that from happening. Why did she think so hard to do so? You know, when we want to do something good, why do we take so long to think? And when we want to do something wrong, why don't we think at all? Right? Why does this happen in life? Is it so difficult to be good? Is it so difficult to have courage? Then why do we take so long in deciding? Is it because when we realize a mistake, then we realize? Is it? Yes. So, right. So, why did she think so hard? Because she learned this lesson. When she learned that Wanda had left, then she realized her mistake. And she did not want that thing to happen again. Now, why do you think Wanda gave Maddie and Peggy the drawings of the dresses? Why did she give them? Because she drew those dresses for them only. The faces of the girls were there. And she had made those dresses. One green dress, one blue dress. And so she had made them specially, right? And do you think Wanda really thought the girls were teasing her? Why not? Do you think the girls were really teasing her? What did Wanda think? Wanda's a very simple, sweet girl. Did she think they were teasing her? She thought that they are her friends. That is why they stop and ask her questions every day. Okay? So she did not actually think of them as, you know, like doing something wrong or hurting her or creating a problem for her. Okay? So we have people like Wanda. She found an escape, you know, from all this teasing and everything. So what did she do? She loved to do painting. But maybe we have people who are more sensitive and they are not able to tolerate all this teasing and bullying. How can we help them? How can we help them? Yes? By not teasing them in the first place. Right? Yes. So I have taught you about inclusion. We have discussed about diversity. How very, very important it is. And it is, you know, teasing. It is not necessarily because of your name or your language or your culture. Sometimes people just love to tease somebody because of their name, because yeah, because he's weaker and smaller. You can bully that person, you can tease that person, right? And sometimes it goes to such an extent that the child might end up getting depressed, might not talk to others. So we must remember, when such a thing happens in a classroom, are you going to be Peggy or are you going to be Maddie? Maddie has learned her lesson that I am going to stand up and I am going to say no. So in life also we should learn, right? And of course here, when people behave like this, when they tease others, does it show their strength or does it show their ignorance? Does it show their strength? Very brave, that is why they're doing this. Does it show they don't know anything? That is why they're behaving like this. It shows their ignorance. And sometimes we have people, you know, who are maybe suffering themselves. Maybe they're coming from such a home where they are not happy, right? So maybe they've had faced such an incident in life. So that is why they go around teasing others also, right? Some people might do it for attention also. So these things are not good. So we must learn to stand up, okay? Yes, so here next question is that these are adjectives describing human qualities. And of course, positive qualities are there and negative. And you can pick up these qualities, adjectives to describe Peggy, Wanda, and Maddie. Now, can we pick up these phrasal verbs? Lined up. Lined up, what does it mean? I have 100 dresses lined up in my closet. Yeah, so they're already arranged over there. Yes, so I have 10 students lined up for the next performance. Prepared, ready. Thought of, can you make a sentence using thought of? Yes? Thought up? Yes? Thought of can be used, thought up also, right? So thought up a few ideas for the class competition. Yes? Took off. Took off. The plane? Took off, right? Yes, on time, right? Okay. By the time I reached the airport, the plane had, right? I was late. Stood by. We've read this now so many times. Can you make a sentence using stood by? Stood by. Like, of course, Maddie stood by her friend while she teased Wanda, isn't it? So these sentences are there. Right, so we should not stand by and watch people being bullied and teased. We need to make a stand. Okay, now here, colors are used to describe feelings. Can we get this now? It's very important. Let us discuss this vocabulary also. Monday morning blue. Monday morning ko blue kyun hota hai? Which page are we doing, Dipansh? Have you find the page? Yes, okay. Monday morning blues. Blue Monday morning. Do you feel like getting up and coming to school? Because you had a nice relaxing Sunday? So Monday morning blues. No, we don't want to get up. Yes. So it is that sadness or depression after a weekend of fun. Go red in the face. When do we go red in the face? When we are? No, when we are sick or embarrassed, angry, ashamed. Look green means when you are about to vomit or you're feeling sick. Okay? Yes. The red carpet. We watched that so many times. The red carpet, right? Rolled out for the VIPs. Yes. A special welcome. Very good. Blue-blooded. Blue blood. Blood is supposed to be the same. Then who has blue blood? Who has blue blood? Of noble birth or from a royal family. Last one. Green belt. A green belt. It could be an area which is there specially dedicated for greenery, right? For taking care of the environment. Is a green play? Yes, right? So an area where construction is prohibited. It's only for the trees. A gray area. gray area, something which is not very clear, an area of subject where matters are not very clear. White flag, when do we show the white flag? Don't fight with me. You can see my white flag. What is that? Sign of surrender. What's a blueprint? I give you a blueprint of the question paper. This is what the paper is going to look like. So I give you an idea. Yes, yes, a detailed plan of thief. Red-handed, the thief was caught red-handed. No, that was white. Red-handed. Yes, while doing something wrong. Green light. When do we see the green light? Yes, to begin an action. Okay. So, ma'am, can we start with our project? Can we start with our activities? So the teacher gave the green light to the students, right? Or the authority gave the green light to for the building of the water, the new stadium. Okay. Clear? Is it clear? So many colors are there. Did you know we had so many? Right. So we have a role play. I think so. We're going to do this also. We will do role play. Now we'll do, I think so, this is the end of this chapter, okay? Right.